Yes, yes, I know. You want to find out which is a better RAW DNG 360 photo camera in 2020. Ricoh Theta Z1 or the brand new Qoocam AK. This video will answer that question and teach you a full HDR workflow for professional virtual tour photography from your boy Hugh, the real professional. Let's roll the cinematic trailer. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. First, let's take a look at outdoor under the sun, the most common scenario. Well, if you are in sunny California, winter here is still sunny and we don't really have weather. From left to right, we have Ricoh Theta Z1 DNG ungraded, Qoocam AK DNG ungraded, and Qoocam AK DNG 8 ungraded. They are all in ISO 100, shutter speed 1 over 25,000. Z1 is in aperture 2.1 and Qoocam AK is in 2.0. So they are similar. Let's quickly compare DNG 8 and just regular DNG in the Qoocam. Let's zoom in my face to 200%. You see, the regular DNG is really noisy around the shadow area and also not as sharp as the DNG 8. We know for sure DNG 8 is always gonna be better than just DNG. So if you own Qoocam AK and you want to take pictures, use DNG 8, not DNG. DNG 8 takes a longer time to process, but the quality increase as you see here, it is well worth it. So now let's focus on comparing Theta Z1 and Qoocam AK DNG 8. On close up, if you look at the chart, they are mostly the same. Qoocam is a little bit more saturated, but in a good way. The first big difference is the dynamic range. As you see, the Theta Z1 is better in shadow. You can see more in the ceiling right here. Flip to the sunny side, you can see it better. The highlight of two camera is exactly the same, but the shadow of Z1 is a lot better without compression artifacts. Zoom in 200% so you can see it better. This is clearly the benefit of a larger sensor. But the bigger issue is sharpness in distant objects. Let me show you. So the Qoocam take 8K photo, in theory, it should see better in distant objects than Z1, which is 6K. But it is not. Look at this focal chart 6 feet away from the cameras. If you cannot see it clearly, let's zoom in 300%. Now, let's have an eyes exam. Put on your glasses. You can clearly see at least 3E on the Z1. On the regular DNG of Qoocam AK, you can only see the biggest E. On the DNG 8, the sharpness is improved, like almost double, but you can only see the second E, and it is very fuzzy. You certainly not able to see the third E. So there you have it. In normal sunlight, the Ricoh Theta Z1 is better. Not by much, but it is better, no doubt about it. What about virtual tour? Which one is better virtual tour camera, especially for an indoor situation with very complicated lightings? Here we have a typical scenario. Outside the window is really, really bright and inside the room is really dark. We actually took HDR bracketed photos But to make things easier for you, let's just pick the middle picture in the selection. Here in the Z1, we pick the ISO 100's shutter speed in 1 over 640 seconds in 2.1 aperture. It is on the dark side, but the window are not overly blown out. Here is my processing. I hit the auto just to get a ballpark of my adjustments. Then I up the exposure to 1.5 in Lightroom Classic. We gonna go extreme here and save the highlights. So we drop it to 100% and lift the shadow to 100%. Pay attention to this crazy color noise, because later on I will show you why DNG 8 is better in this particular scenario. I'm just gonna do my standard thing here. Texture, clarity, and dehaze to 30, and vibrancy to 40. Don't forget to remove chromatic aberration, as it's a reset for all 360 cameras. That's it. I'm not going to add any of my personal settings here for comparison purposes. Explore in Lightroom and pop up Ricoh Theta Z1 Stitcher. Here, you can recalibrate to make a perfect stitch. Something that is definitely missing compared to the Qoocam Studio. There is no camera just come out and has a perfect result. You need to make it better in post-production. Z1 is certainly not a consumer camera, same as Qoocam 8K. If you want to get a great result, you use PT GUI to stitch this thing. For those of you just expect to hit a button and have a perfect result, sorry to break it to you, that never happened. If that is the case, it will put all of us, the professionals, out of jobs. Okay, now we are doing the same with the Qoocam 8K DNG. We use Adobe Camera Raw just to show you a different workflow, but it is exactly the same as Lightroom Classic. You can use both, so make sure you have the exact same processing as the Z1. But now, you see, when I pull down the highlights and rise up the shadows, it is a lot clearer than Z1. There is almost no color noise or noise at all, which is crazy. This is the power of Qoocam DNG 8 that none other camera have. Let's make the final comparison. Left, we have the Z1, and the right, we have the Qoocam 8K. After the exact same processing workflow. Z1 is unusable because of the noise. Qoocam 8K DNG does stand out in this particular scenario. But in the professional world, we always take HDR. Here is the workflow on how to take HDR photos with the Ricoh Theta Z1 mobile app. Open the app and hit the gear icon and choose the multi-bracketing mode. You see I have 8 steps here with different shutter speeds. I can go in and adjust each individual shutter speed setting to have an even spread in exposures. Then I hit the capture button and try to stay absolutely still. That is one bad thing about HDR. There cannot be any motion there. So for outdoor low light situation, which I will show you next, this is close to impossible. Now let me show you a general workflow of HDR merging. So the software I use is Photomatix right here. It is not a free software, but I think it's one of the best professional HDR software you can find on the market. And the most important thing is, it supports 360 image. Go ahead, I organize all 8 of the Ricoh Theta image, I put them as a TIFF file, 16-bit TIFF file, and organize in a folder. And yet, HDR and Ricoh Theta, that's a lot of work. So I skip that organization part to save you some time. Drag all the 8 TIFF image, remember TIFF 16-bit color depth image, into Photomatix. Merge for HDR processing, hit OK. Go ahead and hit Next, choose Merge Options. In here, there's an advanced feature like reduce noise, reduce chromatic aberration, which is a really powerful feature. But to keep it fair, I'm not gonna use this event feature because you might not have Photomatix at all. So now we have the result. As you see, the histogram right here is in the middle. There's a really balanced image. So what I pick, there's a lot of preset here you can use for HDR. Again, depending on what you do, like if you're doing virtual too, or are you doing a hyper-realistic photography, outdoor, indoor, in low light, all this preset, For here, I picked the most neutral one because, again, this is for comparison. And here is the most important part. Remember to check this is a 360 image. If not, you see the final result, you will see a stitch line on the edge in Photoshop and make your HDR merging unusable. So that's why I picked Photomatix, because of this feature. And again, you can pick all these settings to get the result you want. There's a lot of settings here. Again, I'm not going to detail. This is not a Photomatix tutorial. If you guys want to learn more about how I do HDR for my professional client, including multi-million architecture firm and development firm to do their 360 photo capture and also do their 3D rendering for VR headset. So I do have a lot of professional experience to share with you. So if you want to learn that, comment below. And here, I'm not going to do any of my processing and then hit next. So now, Photomatix going to merge all your photo based on your setting. And here is the final result. It's safe to add sharpening here because this photo is 360 aware. But again, to keep it neutral, I'm not going to do any fancy processing. Just going to hit done. And here, we're going to save the final image into a 16-bit TIFF file. So let's take a look at the final result. As you see, the 8 bracketed HDR image from the Ricoh Theta Z1 is a lot better than just one Z1 DNG. Compare it to the DNG 8 result, which is technically also 8 DNG merging. Here is the result. The HDR from Z1 is better, but as you saw the full workflow, which is fast forwarded by me, it took me half an hour at least, and usually it takes me an hour per image if I really want it to look professional. Compared to DNG 8, it is a click of a button. And the result, well, it's not as good as HDR, but not bad at all. So you need to do the math. If you are like me, want to have the absolute best result for the client, then yes, Ricoh Theta Z1 HDR all the way. But if you need to do thousands of photos like this, then maybe Qoocam DNG 8 is a better option for you. So, back to my original question. Which camera is better? Well, it depends. Comment below, tell me what is your workflow and which makes sense to you. Finally, we take a look at low light shot with both cameras. Here, we are in Santa Monica Pier at night after 11 p.m. So it is really dark. You see, the Ferris wheel in the distance is constantly spinning. To capture a clear image to the Ferris wheel, we cannot have a long exposure, low light capture photos. It is not gonna work. You're gonna look blurry, right? So here for the Z1, we decide to keep the ISO to 100 and shutter speed to 1/6 seconds. Same as the Qoocam AK in DNG 8. Here is a dark side of me. As you see, it is noisier in Z1. Look at my pants. But Z1 does look clear in distant objects. You can clearly read the text right here, but not so much in the Qoocam AK DNG 8. In conclusion, I personally think the Ricoh Theta Z1 is still better, but the Qoocam AK is a great, cheap alternative with an impressive result and easy to use workflow. What do you think? Comment below, like this video, and help your boy out. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider subscribing, as I am working on Christmas time to bring you this content. It is a lot of hard work. The best Christmas present to me is to help me to reach 40,000 followers before the end of 2019. Merry Christmas, everybody, and thank you so much for hanging out with me again before Christmas. And now, go spend some quality time with your family. Take some 360 photos and Photoshop your boy Hugh in your family photo and tag me on Instagram, because I have nowhere to go during Christmas, all alone, making more YouTube videos. Hey, see you next year, and don't let your family caught you watching me again.